Muchas veces te dije que antes de hacerlo había que pensarlo muy bien. Que a esta unión de nosotros le hacía falta carne y deseo también. Que no bastaba que me entendieras y que murieras por mí.
And their names were Refugio and Francisco. Refugio is a female name, and his father was Francisco.
Es una carta que Álvaro Obregón escribió a su hijo cuando se iba a la guerra.
And so this is a letter that he wrote to his son. ¿Cuándo qué la guerra?
Iba a la guerra.
¿Siga?
Iba a la guerra Álvaro Obregón.
¿Cuándo él?
Iba a la guerra Álvaro Obregón.
So when he was going to war, this is a letter he wrote to his son.
Y aunque es penoso, lo tienes que decir.
Together through the other rooms, then I can talk about each room. We won't spend a lot of time in the other rooms. This one we'll spend the most time. Okay? Representations of Pascola masks. Pascola masks, for many of you may have them, there's a bunch back there, are made on a regular basis. Pascola dance is done for different kinds of festivals. It's done in during Easter as well. Each dance is represented with different kinds of instruments. So if we were doing a deer dance for Easter, which is not done nearly as commonly as Pascola dancing, there would be certain types of instruments being played. You see the violin played as well, and both those instruments were more recently introduced by the Spanish. Okay. I say a lot about this because we are coming up on Easter. Wednesday is Ash Wednesday, and this is a great room to be in to talk about Wednesday, to talk about Easter and the 40 days of Lent. When the Spanish came, there's a great book, if any of you haven't read it, called Unknown Mexico by Carl Lumholtz. Carl Lumholtz was an anthropologist that started around 1898 to explore the Sierra Madre Occidental. It is still the Bible for anthropology in Mexico. And Carl Lumholtz remarks and talks about the fiestas and how important the fiestas were. And you think about this when the boombox is carrying on Saturday night at your house, okay? So la fiesta was very, very important, always in part of culture. And there were different reasons to do fiestas, you know? And so then the Spanish came and, you know, they kind of incorporated the Catholic religion with the indigenous religion, and the indigenous said, ah, more fiestas. That's great. And so they embraced Christianity. That's my thinking on it. And so one thing to mention is that while they were doing their fiestas, they used to sell tezuino, which is made from corn, and another liquor that they, you know, fermented themselves, and they knew how to deal with it. And they could deal with it. They knew how to make, they had a, for instance, they were going to make a god house. It took 3 days. And they knew that that liquor would, you know, just kind of carry them along. And then came the white man, which they referred to as the Spanish being the white man. And he started distilling liquor on the outside of their fiestas. Mm-hmm. And they couldn't finish their fiestas because the hard liquor was too much for them. So you can think of Tecate the same way, okay? How much it's done to society. So, you know, things really don't change, do they, Rafael? They will go out on a manda, and you've seen them in Alamos for 40 days. They're on a route, and they go around and ask for money and taunt you like clowns, and they don't speak. So they make a vow of chastity, silence, poverty, and the route is made by actually a government, and they call it a governor, and the route is already designated where they stay at night. Blanca's going to take down one of the cajas to show us one of the toys. Yeah, this is great, this caja. It would, and the sand inside moved the figures, you know? Isn't that great?
That is great.
Sí. Here, mostrar tu alado y mostrar ellos como cuando pasan. Isn't that sweet? Yeah, and those are just the way that life was so simple, you know? You can still buy these dolls. Ann Simons has a big collection of these dolls.
Open it up again. Open it up again.
Nuts and spices and
nuts,
all spices and chocolate.
In some part, like in Querétaro, it's only chili, like a basic sauce. And they even call them mole.
Red mole. Mm-hmm. I mean, really, mole indicates how you're doing. Yeah.
Well, mole, right? I mean, it comes from some kind of a crushed up.
Falta carne y deseo también, que no bastaba que me entendieras y que murieras por mí, que no bastaba que en mis fracasos yo me refugiara en ti. Y ahora ves lo que pasó, al fin nació.